sorry, didn't mean it. Just gathering up the last bare necessities. You gotta stock up for a camping trip. You know what they say, survival of the fattest.
Fittest, it's survival of the fittest, Dodo. Whoa, I'm not kidding. Get down here now, Bird Brain.
Stop your sweating, I can't find my long johns.
He's bringing everything but his VCR.
This adventure is for serious campers, right, guys?
Yeah!
Oh, I can't wait for the great outdoors, and I've been studying my manual. I know about this trip, honey.
Mrs. Vestal, haven't you been camping before?
Well, sort of. I saw a movie once. And besides, I've been studying this manual, 101 campsite tips. And besides, we got some experts going with us.
Who? I don't see any experts.
They're our homecoming kids, and I've put them in charge. We're going to call them our big buddies. So, big buddies, what's next?
Well, the key to any trip is safety first.
Wow!
It's okay. I'm all right. My head broke my fall. Oh, wow. Ah. Wow. Flying I can handle. It's just that the flying down stuff is a lot like falling. Yeah. Whew. What am I, a helicopter? I need a runway or something.
Fritz, are you going camping too?
Well, of course I am. I can be the lookout from the treetops. I can scout out the trail as the crow flies. I can send out distress signals. The big buddies invited me along because, well, I'm kind of like a big buddy. I'm a big birdie. Bird buddy. Biggie bird buddy. Biggie buddy birdie bigger. I'm a good camper.
So how far is this camp?
A mere 1.8 kilometers from our present position. Still challenging considering the vast topography that could hinder our progress.
So how far is it? In English.
The campsite's all picked out, Miss Vestal. Where do you see it?
There's crickets and tadpoles, turtles and frogs. Down by the creek bank, by the old holler log.
There's spiders and fireflies, earthworms that crawl.
And small, but I guess my favorite ones of them all are
crickets and tadpoles,
yeah.
Turtles and frogs.
Did you say frogs? I was really enjoying this until you said frogs. Whoa, I don't know about all these frogs, kids. Chaz, what about the frogs?
Green snakes,
tiny tree frogs,
down by the creek bank, by the old holler log. There's spiders and fireflies, earthworms that crawl. Down by the creek bank, by the old holler log.
This frog thing is a joke, right? I need to know, where are these frogs?
Down by the creek bank, by the old holler log.
Oh, here we go, Lord help us.
There's food where we're going. I'm positively, absolutely starved. Why, thank you.
Okay, listen up. You have all been assigned big buddies. Stay with them at all times.
Hey, speaking of big buddies, I was going to bring a friend. If it's okay, I'm gonna fly on to meet him.
Just play it safe.
Yeah, yeah.
We all need to follow these safety rules.
Why?
So we won't get hurt.
Why?
Because we said so.
Why?
Miss Vestal make her stop.
Listen up. Number one, use your whistle only. I repeat, only in case of any emergency. Number two, stay with your big buddies at all times. Number three, if you think you're lost, follow the tree markings. John will be marking the trail as we go. Number four, if you get lost, stay in one place, blow your whistle three times, or yell.
Jordan, but how can we follow the tree markings and stay at one place at the same time?
That's a good question. We all need to ask questions like that. Number five, we must depend on each other. So work as a team and stay with the group. Ricky?
Although we all desire to have an exhilarating experience in the wild, as your trained, appointed, official camp navigator, I must reemphasize the utmost importance of one significant matter.
And what is it?
Oh, safety first.
What was that?
Safety first!
You got it!
Hi, guys!
We might not want to hold you up, but we wanted to bring some goodies for your backpack for your trip.
Oh, thank you from the bottom of my hungry heart.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Miss Gloria, can you and Bill go too?
Well, you know, Bill's idea of camping out is forgetting his toothbrush when he stays at the Holiday Inn. Besides, I have to stay home and protect you. Mark Lowry's coming to town today.
Isn't he the one who teases Bill about being old?
Well, it looks like it's time to go, everybody. Goodbye, Gloria.
Oh, Will, I hope Vestal survives this. Only God would put together such a crazy bunch as that. They always seem to have fun together. They are a beautiful, colorful rainbow.
Created by the
Nathan, I don't need a big buddy. I'm big enough to take care of myself.
Sure you are, Madison. Stop twirling your whistle and try to keep up.
Stop telling me what to do. I'm going my own way or nobody bosses me.
Madison, you're going to make us late. Madison? Madison? Where are you? Oh, boy. Stop playing around! Oh, no.
So how far is it now?
Due to the bipolar magnetic waves emanating from those mountains, my instruments are fallible and any data would be inconclusive.
Oh, forget it.
I think I've got a hitch in my get-along. My book doesn't cover get-alongs, but it is good for mosquitoes. Got one.
The woods are just so unsanitary. Could we hide where there aren't so many trees and dirt?
Are we there yet?
According to my calculations, it's just 20 degrees over that river and through those woods.
To Grandmother's house we go!
Those babies, who needs them? I'm not scared of nothing. It's the bears. Mr. George, you scared me half out of my wits.
Since you scared me half out of my wits, I guess that makes us a couple of half wits, huh? I was just out here looking for the campers. Have you seen them? Do you want to see them?
I think they're lost.
They are? That can be scary, being lost. You're probably so upset because you're worried about them, right? When I get to worry, I always go fishing. I think that's just what we ought to do. Come on, Madison.
Have you ever heard God talking? He does, you know, to us. But most of the time, we're just not listening. God loves to talk to little boys while they're fishing. That seems to be the time boys listen best. It's the only quiet time there is for wishing. It's the only time when God and boys can rest.
You know, a boy can almost hear God whisper sometimes out here fishing. I wonder if he's just trying to tell me something. Excuse me just a minute, Mr. George, while I just sit here and listen for a spell.
You go right ahead, Madison. You go right ahead, son. God loves to talk to little boys while they're fishing. That seems to be the time boys listen best. There's something about a boy who's good at fishing. God knows he'll make a very special friend. A boy who learns to listen while he's fishing can hear God when it's time to fish for men.
talk to boys while they're fishing.
That's right. That seems to be the time boys listen best. It's the only quiet time there is for wishing. It's the only time when God and boys can rest.
Mr. George, I'm glad we went fishing today.
Me too, Madison. Me too.
I got one.
I got another boot for my collection. Madison, you may have thought you were all alone when you were lost, but the Bible says God is a very present help in the time of trouble. He was with you all the time.
And so was I.
Why did you leave me? You said you'd never leave me. Why'd you do it?
Madison, I thought I'd teach you a lesson. The rules weren't made to keep you from having fun. They're made to keep you safe. Even when you didn't want me around, I was still there the whole time.
You know, God is just like that. He's always, always watching over us. And he gives us rules to keep us safe. So, the next time you're frightened, and you hear something scary, boy, that sounds scary. Sounds close. Do you know what it is?
No, but it's standing right behind you.
Whoa, put those things away. Who do you think you are, the Musketeers? No more caffeine for any of you.
They were gonna shish kebab me.
Relax, Bailey. We've been looking everywhere for you guys.
Sorry, he's with you? We thought he was a dangerous animal.
Yeah? When's the last time you saw a man-eating donkey?
Huh? Well, I've never seen a talking donkey.
Well, it seems he had an ancestor once that was used by God to talk to the man on his back. Kinda nuts, huh?
Balaam, I've read that story in the Bible.
That's him. My name is Bailey. I come from a long and proud line of talking donkeys.
This is great. A donkey that can talk.
So what am I? Chop liver?
Huh? Hey, Betty, do you like to fish?
I don't know, but I like to tell jokes.
Me too. Come on, we can tell them on the way back to camp.
Birds talk for hundreds of years, nobody notices. Big deal. Then a donkey opens his mouth and everybody goes crazy. It's a news flash. Stop the presses.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Amos.
Amos who?
A mosquito bit me.
Have you ever seen a man eating fish?
No.
Yes, at a seafood restaurant.
Oh, what do you call a fish with two knees?
I don't know.
A toony fish.
Okay, guys, this is it. What do you think?
Oh, he leads me beside cool waters. Thank you, Lord.
Ooh.
I'm feeling faint. Truly I am. Why, thank you.
Has anybody seen Madison or Nathan? They must be around here somewhere. Oh, well, at least surely nothing else can go wrong.
Well, looks like this rain's here to stay for a while. Sorry about your camping trip. You stay here as long as you like, and I'm gonna go out and keep an eye out for your friends.
Thanks a lot, Reggie.
Well, it's what I do.
Hey guys, whether we're indoors or outdoors, we still have to set up camp. Everybody, make me proud.
How can we, when everything we own is soaked? This camping trip is ruined!
Show off? I blame myself. I should have checked the future atmospheric conditions with my weather scope software.
This weather also wrinkled my brand new camping ensemble.
I'm tired.
I cut my finger.
I have a blister.
The wood's wet.
I ripped my pants.
I've lost my appetite.
Now that's amazing. Come on, guys, remember, this is the day the Lord hath made. Let us
pack up and go home.
Oh, Lord, we're going to need some supernatural help with this.
My body itches.
How can this be? There's no TV, CDs, or Nintendo.
Anybody got a virtual reality Game Boy?
God bless the days that don't go our way. We sure have plenty of them.
My hair is getting frizzy. This pressure makes me dizzy.
The wood is wet.
I hate to sweat.
I really have to go.
Everybody, I want you to meet my new friend. This is Bailey.
Hi, Bailey.
Hello. Are we having fun yet?
We are now.
I'll hold my head up high, ask the Lord to bless my mess. When I'm flustered, I will muster up a real stick to witness. I will try and try again until my own self I'll be true grit. On with the show.
I could ring her.
I have mosquito bites, a bee sting. I stomp my toe.
Oh, I'm bleeding!
God bless the days that don't go our way. We sure have plenty of them.
I need a good physician. It could be malnutrition.
Because our girls,
God made girls lead him in all time love.
Always says something about being happy while you're young, right? And let your heart give you joy.
Yeah, a happy heart makes a face cheerful. See?
I always say it's not a camp until you got a good campfire. We got a fireplace, so let's get one going.
God put the earth together.
I know.
How did he know how to make a creeping?
I know.
And put trees up for shade.
I know.
And put all the stars up in the sky.
I know. It's a miracle.
Oh, why didn't you just say so? Stars without making a sound. Why can't they crash when they're spinning around?
What holds me up when the world's upside down?
I know, it's a miracle.
Who tells the oceans or the stop on the sand?
What keeps the water back from
the rules I don't understand.
I know. It's a miracle. It's a miracle just to know God is with me wherever I go. It's a miracle as big as can be that he can make a miracle of me. A miracle of me.
He shows the birds how to make a good nest. How can the geese fly so far without rest?
Why do you birds go south and not west?
I know.
Brown seeds so tiny and dry, burst into green, grow up so high, and shoot out blossoms of red by and by.
I know it's a miracle. It's a miracle just to know God is with me wherever I go.
It's a miracle as big as can be that he can make a miracle of me.
Spring makes a brook, and a brook makes a stream. The stream makes the river water fresh as can be.
Who puts the salt in when it gets to the sea?
I know, it's a miracle.
There are thousands of people in cities I see. The world must be crowded, as crowded can be.
But God knows my name, and he cares about me.
Yes, he really does, darling.
I know. Now that doesn't sound like any animal I've ever heard.
Well, hello, boys. Welcome. We're the homecoming kids. And the company.
Hey, we thought we heard some music coming from the cabin.
Yeah, we thought we'd come and check it out.
And ask for some help. It seems when we went camping, we forgot a very important item.
An item we all need for daily survival.
I don't think we could make it through the night without it.
We'll do our best. What's so important you hiked all the way over here?
Ketchup!
Ketchup? You're kidding. Way out here?
Everything's gotta have ketchup. What do you think we look like, barbarians?
Boys, when you go on a camping trip, you only take the bare essentials. In all my days of camping, I've never known anyone to bring a bottle of ketchup. Vestal, can you believe that?
George?
So, do you like music too?
Yeah, you might say that. We make our own kind of music.
Oh, let's hear some, please. Pretty please.
Okay. Hit it.
Later. Thanks for the ketchup.
Bye.
I see some mighty sleepy faces. I think it's time we turned in and get some sleep.
I'm scared. I've never slept away from home before.
Oh, well, you can sleep with me, darling. And besides, you don't have to be afraid. God has his angels watching over us all the time with mighty swords drawn.
Where?
All around us. He always has his angels ready to protect God's children there.
Wow. Let's say a prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for this great world and for all the wonderful creations you've given us to discover. Send your guardian angels tonight to protect these beautiful children. In the name of Jesus, amen. God has his angels watching over all his children. All night, all day, God's angels are watching over you.
Asleep, his child peace will attend me all. Breakfast if I don't get some breakfast.
French toast fast, I'm impossible to live with.
This floor is hard to sleep on without a pillow.
I slept great.
Of course you did. I was your pillow.
You and me both. Boy, when that thunder started, I thought they were all gonna pile in here on me.
Jordan, it's hard enough getting up out of a real bed, much less this hard floor for this old man. Thank you, buddy.
Hey, sunshine!
I can hardly wait till our next adventure.
Oh, let's get through with this adventure first.
Come on, campers. Let's start the hike home. It's a new day.
Breaking in the new day. Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Breaking in the new day.
Come on!
Good morning, sunshine. How do you doodly-do? You've been shining round the world while we've been snoozing.
We're up, we're busting loose. Come on, work our play.
We're rising to the feeling of a brand new day. Breaking in the new day. Breaking in the new day.
We are breaking in the morning with a hippity-hip hooray. We'll be breaking in the new time with a symphony to the day. Yay, yay.
We're headed for the evening, singing on our way.
We are breaking, 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 breaking in the new day.
With a hippity hip hooray,
we'll be breaking in the moonshine.
Is important.
And the rules are to keep us safe, so we should follow them.
God is a great God. Even though I don't know how He does it all,
God protects us when we're afraid.
And we're never alone because He's always with us.
Good. Now I want all of you to come back and join us next time, okay?
Okay! Yeah.
Who knows where we'll go next?
Why, thank you.
Come, I'll take you there, and we will find.
too.